Welcome back to Up North at 4, and joining us now, Dana Joel Nicholson. And Dana, I'm going to be honest, yeah. I'm a little unsure of how to properly address you or how to properly introduce you to the audience.
Okay.
Because you're a singer, you're a mm-hmm. musician, you're an actor, now you're a photographer.
Maybe it's easier what doesn't Dana do.
Yeah, what don't you do? Do you do taxes as well?
I hate doing taxes.
Okay, so he's not a tax expert.
I'm not a math guy.
Okay, you know, good to know.
My brother got the math brain from dad, and gotcha. I got the musician brain from my mom. So.
Well, there we go.
There it goes, musician.
Musician,
yes.
Perfect. So, we'll start right there. You said you got the genes from your mom, and you've kind of vaulted that into a career, right? Where did the performing art bug kind of catch on for you?
Well, really the first thing that I did when I was in fourth grade, my mom took me to audition for the Moline Boys Choir in Moline, Illinois. Mm-hmm. And from then on, I was accepted into that choir and was there for a few years. Was very fortunate to kind of get, I was a soloist for mm-hmm. many of the numbers that we did. And then after that, it wasn't until about my my freshman year of high school was the first time I took the stage, in a musical.
Yeah.
Camelot.
There we go.
That's always a good one to land on.
Yeah, I was, second guy to the left in the background and whatever, but I caught
the
bug.
You were in the show.
It was great, though. It was a really cool experience, and I became, after doing all of the shows in high school, I became a musical theater major, mm-hmm. Missouri mm-hmm. State. Back when it was Southwest Missouri State, which I actually got two diplomas because I was right on the cusp, so that's kind of cool.
There you go.
One of each name, mm-hmm. but after I graduated in 2004, moved to Chicago for a stint, got my first national tour, and then, kind of bounced around. I moved from Chicago to Kansas City, Missouri. I was there for 5 years, did a lot of great, great shows. I like to call it guerrilla theater because it wasn't necessarily they weren't, equity shows, but uh-huh. they were locals, and I got to say, the talent level in Kansas City, Missouri is beyond anything mm-hmm. that you would expect.
Yeah.
Had a lot of fun there. Was there for 5 years. And then the Book of Mormon found me in KC and plucked me out and put me on the first national tour for 3 years of my life.
Wow.
Living on the road. So, yeah.
All right. Well, true story. I lived in Moline, Illinois for a while.
Did
that
you
was
really?
A very cool place to live.
Okay.
I liked it. I loved it there. I really did.
Yeah.
And then so is your, where do you thrive? Are you thriving in, do you sing? Is it instruments? Acting? Where is your happy spot?
You know, music was my first passion.
Yeah.
Singing
mm-hmm.
was the first thing that really inspired me and I really connected to. But it's tough because I'm one of those people that's like, I don't know whether to bill myself as a singer, actor, not so much dancer anymore, or the other way around, actor, singer, and not so much dancer anymore. Mm. But I definitely love acting. It's really something to be able to throw yourself into a role and have it completely just take over your whole psyche. It's kind of weird. It's kind of freaky.
I get it.
But it's a lot of fun.
The live audience thing is a thing. It's a thing.
Totally.
Right? Like we love what we do here, but it's different because the people are behind the camera. Right?
Absolutely.
But the live theater thing, I've had that bug, and it's just there's nothing else like it.
I see why it's addicting.
Yeah. I mean, especially when it's a live stage situation, whether it's just me doing my solo gigs or a full on production, there's an energy exchange that happens with mm-hmm. an audience. And when you go through those moments and hear the gasps, mm-hmm. hear someone cry, hear someone laugh.
The screams.
And then you get to the end of that and you take a bow and there's,
applause,
however many people that are in the audience that are giving you applause and kind of giving you that energy back,
yeah.
kind of fuels you up for the next one.
Absolutely.
And that's something I really, really appreciate.
Totally. I love just hearing you talk about your passions. It's so fun just to listen to you describe it, like what you're feeling on stage. And I've got more questions for you, Dana.
Sure.
But we're going to take a quick break. Be right back after this. And welcome back to Up North at 4 as Theo gets the belly rub, loving life. We're joined by Dana Joel Nicholson.
It's a good life.
It is. Actor, musician, now photographer. And so, Dana, we were just chatting about your acting career and kind of the thrill you got being on stage. But you mentioned before that your first true passion was music, and it was singing. It's not often we get people on the show who sang the national anthem at an NBA playoff game. And just the sports nerd in me needs to know, how did that happen?
Okay, so Book of Mormon was actually in San Francisco. We played there for, I think, like 3 months or so.
Okay.
And somebody from the team called over to the theater and asked if there was a cast member that would be available to come and sing. And I had previously done it for the home opener of the Orlando Magic. And so I kind of had already had a good run at
it. Casual, yeah.
So like, he's done it twice now.
yeah, it was fun. So Wrigley Field, you're up next. Hopefully.
When that call comes, did you get nervous? Is that a thing?
Yes, it's totally a thing.
Like the words.
It wasn't the words. It was just the fact that when people say it's an incredibly tough song to sing, it is. It really is.
Yeah.
It's got a very large range. Getting the right key, is.
I was going to ask you, I can't hear notes.
Okay.
So if Nate belts out some notes right now, can you tell me what note they are?
I can't. That's a perfect pitch thing. It's not like a, that's a G.
Dana, you're supposed to come through for me here. I want to hear Nate sing on TV.
That was just a weird roundabout way of
it. Just trying to set you up.
Trying to get me
to sing. I got shut down.
Oh, my gosh. But Dana, even to this day, you're still performing. You're still singing. You traveling with a group? Is it just yourself?
It's just me. So long and the short of it, I basically came to the family cabin in just outside of Land O'Lakes in fall of 2020. Mm-hmm. I was living in New York City. Obviously, COVID had taken hold, and as a vocalist and someone who, obviously doesn't play around with my lungs, I figured this is pretty much the safest and smartest place for me to be. And some life happened along the way, some loss happened along the way, mm-hmm. and long and the short of it, I was just like, okay, well, this has always been my happy place. Why not stay here and see if I can, enjoy an actual life in this area. Mm-hmm. And so, especially once everybody started building these outdoor stages around the area, mm-hmm. I was like, well, I can fill those. So it's me, a microphone stand, my sound system, my laptop right next to me, and some lights that I've got a remote control for, and it's just a one-man show.
You're making it happen.
It's been fun, yeah. I'm very fortunate. This summer is going to be kind of fun. I'm going to do a little bit more bouncing around than I have the last couple years. Mm-hmm. But every Wednesday, you're going to be able to catch me in Minocqua at a place called the Thirsty Whale.
Ah, the whale.
And then on Thursdays, I will be at Sweetwater in Eagle River. Bouncing around a little bit more on the Fridays and Saturdays, and then my Sundays are going to be in every other Sunday at a place called the Boathouse in Conover.
There we go.
So that's going to be fun.
Cooking some cool events up here.
Yeah, it's been a good time. I've been very fortunate to get some good spots along the last couple of years here.
And also you've picked up photography in the last few years as well.
Yeah, that one came out of nowhere.
I was going to ask, where did that come from?
So I've always kind of had an eye, and it's always kind of just been a hobby.
Yeah.
Never did I think that I was going to turn this into something that I would like turn into a business. But it all came to be last year. My aunt, who also lives in this area, she was retiring. She was going through retirement, and she has a beautiful home, and I've kind of always been the person that would go and help her pick out some pictures and things to put on her wall space.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I thought, you know what? Why don't I go back through some of the stuff that I've taken? Mm-hmm. And it's a little more personal. I made my first canvas for her as a retirement gift. And then we both kind of looked at it and she goes, Dana, you could sell this. She was like, you need to go back and look through the stuff that you've already taken. And what I really love about it, though, is that it's a lot of stuff that I either took on our lake, on Crystal Lake, or within maybe a 5 to 8 mile radius. So it is very Northwoods specific and personal. And it's, this is, like I said, this place does my soul good. Mm-hmm. I love the nature. It's one of the reasons that I don't really miss the city. But to be able to showcase some of my favorite, moments and try and capture them to the best of my ability, I am in no way, shape, or form a professional photographer in that I can, I'm not going to talk to you about settings on the camera.
Yeah, totally.
But I've been very fortunate to capture some really, really beautiful things.
We're going to chat a little bit more. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back after this on Up North at 4. Long enough to get you. Hey, welcome back to Up North at 4, joined by Dana Joel Nicholson, actor, musician, vocalist. You're still performing on stage. Of course, you're going to be doing that throughout the summer. But one thing, Dana, that you've kind of picked up throughout your time since coming to the Northwoods here a few years ago is nature photography. And you send along some examples of your work. And it's good. I'm not just saying this just to hype you up. It's good. Like, good. I would put this in my living room,
right? Well, thank you. I'm not biased then.
Okay, perfect. Yeah.
Look at the color.
Hey, look at that.
I was gonna say, yeah, just the color is actually what stood out to me for it. And like you said, you just always had an eye. Is it just a certain colors in the sky speak to you? What do you look for?
Different things at different times. Sometimes it's lighting, sometimes it's color. Sometimes it's a lack of both, just depending on what the scenario is. But I've really been very fortunate to be able to be given a space, a place that I have performed at before in Eagle River called the Blue Heron, they put up all of my stuff. So if you go into the back party room area of the Blue Heron in Eagle River, you'll be able to see all of my stuff on display, and they are all also available for purchase there. So
awesome.
You can go ahead and take a look in person, see if you like anything.
Your story is like one of my favorites.
I know. Things just happen to you, they just happen. In a good way.
I try and put good things out, and good things usually come
out.
It's the way the universe
karma works.
It's karma, law of attraction, whatever you want to call
it. And it's a beautiful thing when it happens and it works out for you. So Dana, you got a lot of stuff coming up this summer, a lot of shows, a lot of gigs. I'm sure you're always taking
a lot of pictures along the way.
What's a good way to kind of for people at home to follow you along? You're on social?
My Facebook page, Dana Joel Nicholson. If you guys are interested after seeing some of those shots, you can reach me at danajoelnicholson@gmail.com. That's my, and you can reach me for either gigs or picture interest.
Send you an email
right now. I like it.
Jeff's going to do it on live TV. Dana, I appreciate you stopping by. This has been so much fun.
Absolutely.
We're going to take a break, wrap up the show after this on Up North at 4.